Now your WAPT.com webcast and Storm Shield 16 weather.
Good morning. I'm 16 WAPT's Megan West with our WAPT.com news and weather headlines. This morning, crews are searching the reservoir for the body of a man who fell in the water during a fishing accident. You're looking out from our spillway cam now. It happened last night near the lower side of the spillway in Madison County. Authorities tell us the man is believed to be in his 50s. In other news, Bulldog Nation is celebrating its first win of the season this morning. State easily handled Memphis 59-14 last night at the Liberty Bowl. Vic Ballard rushed for 166 yards and three touchdowns, while quarterback Chris Relf completed 13 of 21 passes and two touchdowns for Mississippi State. Now we'll send things over to meteorologist Megan Quigley watching a tropical depression in the Gulf. Megan.
That's right, Megan. Right now things are fairly quiet here, but we are starting to see some of that rain moving onshore in parts of New Orleans and also the Mississippi Gulf Coast. Now we do have tropical depression number 13 with winds around 35 miles per hour at this time, but I am expecting it to strengthen and become Tropical Storm Lee before it makes landfall on the Louisiana coastline and then continues its journey through Mississippi. So for today, things will be fairly quiet with just a couple of storms across the south as that depression draws closer. But as we get into the overnight hours and especially into Saturday, that's when we will start to see that rain becoming a little bit more widespread in coverage as that system makes its way towards the coast. Now, two things could happen here because we do have a cold front that's going to be moving on in. The first one is that front moves through and the storm moves through the central portion of the state. The second case is that we see that front moving through and it moves the system more along the coastline towards the Florida Panhandle. Right now I'm leaning more towards case one where we see it coming through the central portion of the state. But either way, we're going to have plenty of rainfall here and possibly some flooding problems as well, especially along the coast where we're going to see about more than 12 inches through Monday. Now as you start to work your way inland, we do start to see those totals going down just a little bit, but still too much rain at one time through the upcoming weekend. So once again, today fairly quiet, but then after that, our rain chances increase for Saturday, Sunday, and into Monday with tropical downpours possible and also some windy conditions before we finally see things getting a little bit better as we get into Tuesday.